What's up YouTube, this is Pear, and you have almost certainly already heard the term artificial intelligence, and you're probably wondering about a few things like, is it real, is it dangerous, or is it good, and does it even affect me at all? Well, yes, it's real without any doubt. It can be dangerous, but it also can do many good things, and at least if you are somehow using technology and the internet, and you are watching this video, that means you are most likely using the internet, it in any case does affect you. And that is exactly why it is so important to talk about the opportunities as well as the risks that come with this somewhat new technology. This first one out of two videos will give you a basic introduction into what AI actually is and can do. Timestamps are in the description. And in the second video, we'll then talk about opportunities and risks. So, let's go! In the normal, so-called imperative programming, you give the computer step-by-step instructions on what to do. You describe every situation that the program can encounter and tell the computer what to do in this situation. That also means that your program is not able to handle new situations, situations that you haven't described. What you tell the computer could, for example, be something like this. Pause the video if you want to check it out in detail. On the right, you can see how this looks in a real programming language. This one is currently my favorite, and it's called Python. We use, for example, if and else statements, like these ones here, to describe a situation and what to do in that situation. This does, of course, have some limits of what we can do. So imagine, you want to program a self-driving car and describe every situation that it can get into using these if and else statements that we have just seen. Even at the single intersection, maybe with a defective traffic light, you could imagine hundreds of different situations. Doing this for all the millions of intersections in the world, that's impossible to manage. And this is where AI comes into play. There actually is no clear definition of what counts as an AI and what not. But in general, there should be no need to describe every situation, but the program should be able to make own decisions, even for new situations that you haven't described, so that it does not follow a simple to-do list, but actually is a bit closer to something like intelligent. There are different ways and ideas of achieving this. Amongst other things, you could tell the computer a general strategy to apply, for example in games, that it can use in new situations. You could also describe the general situation and the desired outcome, and let it find out, by trial and error, which strategies work best. For example, you could describe the rules of chess and what winning looks like. Another example is the kind of famous monkey-banana problem, where you have a monkey in a room with a table and a banana is hanging from the top, and you just describe this room and how the monkey is able to move, and let the computer find out for itself that the monkey can push the table under the banana, climb onto it, and finally grab the delicious banana that it has been working so hard for. The last way of achieving AI that I want to quickly show you is to give the computer lots of data and let it learn from this data. This is a bit like throwing a lot of French books and their English translations at the computer and saying, "I want you to learn French, now go figure it out for yourself," which works amazingly well if you have enough data. This is called deep learning and is achieved with a so-called neural network that models the, very basic, look of a real brain, where every small part of the data is mapped onto an input neuron. And each neuron plays its own small part in getting the desired result step by step over several layers of neurons, until the information is combined into the output. And with each piece of training data, the network adjusts the rates of the connections between the neurons. If you want some more detailed input on this specific topic, and some of the other topics too, check out the videos I linked in the description. So all in all, in AI programming there is no need to describe every situation, but the computer is able to deal with new situations, based on a strategy, trial and error, or on training with huge amounts of data. We differentiate between two concepts of AI, the so-called strong AI and the weak AI. Strong AI is also called artificial general intelligence, and this term already describes it extremely well. It is an AI that can successfully master any cognitive task that a human can solve, just faster and better, ideally. That means it's a general problem-solving machine that can be applied to any situation and any problem, and that maybe even has a real consciousness. Weak AI, on the contrary, is an AI that is made for a single, specific purpose and can only be used there. For example, driving a car, playing chess, or recognizing pictures of dogs. When we talk about artificial intelligence in the future, many people tend to think about what science fiction movies also show quite often. A nearly almighty robot AI that becomes an evil, humanity-oppressing dictator of the whole world. And while this is great to make thrilling movies, we are nowhere near that right now. At the current state of research, there is no real progress on building a strong AI, which would be necessary for this scenario to be able to happen, and is controversial if there ever will be a strong AI. So we can worry about this when research maybe, at some point, gets a little closer to actually developing strong AI. But right now, there are other, more real dangers to think about. But first, let's see what AI can do for us and what opportunities it holds. As we have already seen, AI can learn from data. And it can also deal with huge amounts of data. Additionally, it can create own data with trial and error simulations and learn from that too. Finally, AI is able to take every little part of the data into account, even the smallest details that humans would most likely not see. And based on this data, a program can be able to make decisions, like what chess move to play next, make classifications, like dog, no dog, and control if some input fits to what it has learned, and correct or improve the input if necessary. An example for this would be spell checking. This can be used in many, many different ways, so I just want to show you some examples of different fields where AI technology is used. In healthcare, AI can be used to diagnose diseases, for example cancer, based on pictures of cells from the body with an extremely high accuracy. In agriculture, AI can be used to grow crop plants way more efficiently by finding out which plants need exactly how much fertilizer and which don't need any, by driving over a field of plants and filming it, and therefore help to use less resources to grow more crop plants. In social media, AI is used to detect facial features in pictures and automatically suggest which friends to tag. And it also is used to detect hate speech, racism or sexism, and therefore helps preventing posts like these from appearing. Companies can use AI chatbots for their customer support, as for example the online bank N26 does, and only redirect you to a human if the chatbot cannot help you. In the car industry, AI is used in driver assistance systems that help staying in your lane instead of accidentally drifting out of it. Or that help keeping enough distance while driving instead of, yeah, not doing so. And in marketing and comfort, AI can make recommendations on what you could like to buy, watch, read. Amazon's customers who viewed this item also viewed is powered by AI technology, as are Netflix recommendations on what you could like watching. And actually, studies show that 75% of series and films that are watched on Netflix were recommended by the algorithm, so this seems to work really well. Well, these were just some examples, so as you can see, AI is used in many various fields and already has a big impact on us today. But there are also many opportunities that it holds for the future. And we will have a look at some of those, as well as current risks that can come with AI, in the next part of this video. Make sure to check it out. Smash that like button on this video. Thanks for watching so far, and enjoy your day.